once again, for tuning in. First off, today we're going to talk about Love and Hip Hop Hollywood's own Hazel E. Or Nasal He.
Okay.
Big nose bitch. I don't know. So she supposedly said these comments or co-signed the comments of Rose Burgundy, which happens to be her boyfriend that she pays to be with. He made mention of gays burning in a fiery death in hell or something of that nature, which is very offensive and unacceptable. She co-signed it. It was talked that she was getting fired from Love and Hip Hop because of the remark. And now they're saying that wasn't the reason. It was something that took place on the reunion, which I'm totally confused because she was bickering back and forth with a cast member and then she was gone. So I don't know what that was about. Maybe they'll reveal it in the second part of the reunion. I don't know. I just feel like those remarks were very unacceptable. If she got fired for them, if she didn't, whatever. You got to watch what you say. Even co-signing, you got to watch that. I know she didn't tweet that or type that or say that, but she co-signed it and that's a problem. It's not cool. We're supposed to be tolerant of everyone. However, you feel it's okay. You can have your feelings, no problem. But what you need to do is keep them in your head. Everybody doesn't need to know how you feel because it's very offensive. And just because you don't understand another person's personal plight and how they live, it does not give you the right to make them feel bad, like they're doing something wrong. Aside from all that, and me being very studious, fuck that bitch. Let me tell y'all something. I'm so tired of that whole Hazel E. This is the thing. She's like a non-motherfucking factor to me, really. In the words of my girl, she is a non-fucking factor. Really, she turns up all of a sudden on this season, and it's like, what is going on? Does she think she's part of a gang now? Is she tough? Is she acting as hard as her ass? Maybe that big hard ass makes her feel hard. I don't know what's going on.
Look hard.
Yeah, that shit look hard as rock, like a sack of rocks.
Okay.
Wow, you might break your hand hitting it. I don't understand what's going on with Nasal He, in the words of Masika. Or who's a... Who
yes.
is her? What y'all feel about this?
Oh, honey. Hazel, give it up, girl. Give it up, honey.
They give
it
up.
I'm just sick of it, girl. Ain't you tired yet, honey? It's my whole thing is, Hazel E, you're always in the studio, but I don't hear a track. You're making all this money, but I don't see where. But, I mean, you have all these albums, and you have all of these books.
Where are they?
I don't know where at, Hazel. Like, I mean, honey, you are the biggest joke, honey. That's where the story ends for me with Hazel E. And Hazel E, with this shit, it wouldn't even affect me. You're ignorant as fuck. Of course, anybody you would deal with would be ignorant as fuck. For this little boy who you allowed to play in your male parts. I mean... This little boy, for him to even speak, honey, muzzle him, okay? Tell him to only speak when he's spoken to, honey. I just don't even understand why this shit is even make headlines. My whole thing is, Hazel, aren't you friends with Sir Brock or whatever his name is? Aren't y'all best friends? So why the fuck are you even co-signing stupidity, honey? And while you're worried about gays burning in hell, honey...
That
you need to burn that fucking nose, okay? snip that bitch off and burn it, honey, because they gave you the wrong one, okay? You should have left that bitch bent up like a motherfucking pretzel. That's what you should have did. Because, bitch, what you have now is ridiculous. It's I mean, that shit is ridiculous.
Period.
Oh, ma'am.
Let me tell y'all about this dill pickle nose ass bitch. I cannot stand Hazel E, honey. I cannot stand her with that bad, horrible shape and that ugly face that should be covered in a paper bag
at all times.
And she wanted to talk and co-sign that all gays should burn in hell. Well, her man should be the first one there because white is one of the girls, sis. And you or your man can't sit with us, baby.
At all, baby.
Both of y'all are jokes. You bitches couldn't sit with us if we were in a waiting room of the hospital, baby. You couldn't ask her.
You'll be on the other side, okay, bitch.
Girl, I can't. I don't even got nothing else to say. Y'all take the floor.
Hey, I can't. Why is she a factor? I don't understand. What is she? And my whole thing too, even on like on the episode where like was it the last episode or something where Ray J was like trying to tell her, I was glad he said that to her. He was like, you need to stop worrying so much about what people are saying to you and just do you. I think that would make you so much, not only a more likable character on the show, but just a better person in general. You care about what so many other fucking people think about you and say about you all the fucking time, Hazel. It makes you look like a joke as a grown woman, and it makes you look insecure as fuck.
She's definitely insecure. You see what that body used to do on season one?
I can't. I fucking can't. Girl. And she always talking about how expensive, like, my, this shit is expensive.
She said that Prada bag on the table.
I know.
The
nail. Yeah, you throwing shit all out the motherfucking bag. Like, she screams so insecurity over the camera. And that's the thing. I'm not going to say, because I don't know Hazel, I'm not going to say I don't like her, but I don't like the way she comes out off over the film. That is overkill. It just screams insecurity. I'm not bringing all this shit, throwing shit, and talking about I'm booked and busy, right. I'm not the baddest bitch, and this is my city, and this, that, and the third. Whatever, who cares? Song. What the hell are you talking
Girl,
about?
Girl, good night. In the words of Shawnee from Basketball Wives, I am absolutely done with Hazel E.
I am completely done with Hazel E, honey.
Thanks for your services.
Bitch, keep it moving, honey.
Please, no, don't come back. Don't come back. All of this shit, I wish her and Masika would fight it out and be
okay,
done.
Okay, and be done.
Shit.
And be done.
I'm glad Masika smashed her, though.
And yes, I was so glad she did. She was like, honey, she said, bitch.
She said, young man.
Masika made sure she had a good grip on that head, honey. She was said, like, bitch. Yes.
Donatella was like, oh my God. Her wig. I can't believe it.
She was like, her wig is coming off. Her wig is coming off.
Because it's so entirely ridiculous. I can't believe I'm in here with these bitches. They're very crazy. Oh my
like,
God.
It needs to be fished down.
This is not what we do. That's where we not come from. I just can't believe why we can't all get along. My name is Donatella.
Honey, that shit was ridiculous as fuck, that's honey.
Team Alexis.
Oh my God. Yes, honey. That's a whole nother video.
Oh, how Lexus, honey. Anywho.
Honey, popping that pussy for dollars.
Yeah. High pussy. I'm with you. I'm here for it.
Yes, ma'am, honey.
Well, I guess that concludes this video, guys. Thanks again for tuning in to Porch Talk. Catch us next time. Bye. Make sure you choose Rocky Road Productions LLC Porch Talk to feed your entertainment needs. And you can do that by following us on Facebook, Instagram. Make sure you like this video and share it with all your family and friends. Tag somebody in it, why don't you? And don't forget to comment down below and let us know how you feel. And before you leave, make sure you subscribe. That's right. You'll catch us every week. Looking forward to see you again next time. Bye.